This is Tennis Now. Roger Federer and Rafael Nadal are back in action this week. Petra Kvitova, Caroline Wozniacki, Marty Fish, and Fernando Verdasco are in action at the Hotman Cup in Perth, Australia. Andy Murray hires Yvonne Lendl to help him prepare for the Australian Open. And Samantha Stosur signs a new deal with ASICS. All of this and more on Tennis Now. And welcome to Tennis Now's twice-a-week news update show. We've got all you need to know about what's going on in tennis. I'm James Watterson, and Happy New Year! We've wasted no time in getting back to the tennis season as the top pros start their preparation for the Australian Open. Andy Murray also hired a new coach, and Samantha Stosur signed a new clothing and shoe deal with ASICS. We've got all that and more, so stay tuned. This week, Roger Federer and Rafael Nadal are the top seeds at the ATP World Tour 250 event in Doha, while Andy Murray headlines the Brisbane International. Finally, Janko Tipsarevic, Nicolas Almagro, and Stanislas Wawrinka are the top men at the Chennai Open. Although it's the first week of the new season, we're already looking at some compelling early round matchups. In Doha, Federer faces an instant challenge in former top 10 player Nikolai Davydenko, who he lost to in the semifinals here 1 year ago. Within the last 2 years, Davydenko has fallen from the top 10 to his current rank of number 41, but that doesn't mean he isn't a dangerous opponent. Still, Federer has a 15-2 record against him, which means he should be favored to advance. If the Swiss gets past Davydenko, he faces little challenge until the semifinals, where he could possibly meet third-seeded Joe Wilfried Tsonga. Meanwhile, Nadal faces Philipp Kohlschreiber in the first round. None of the seeded players in Nadal's half of the draw, Viktor Troitsky, Mikhail Yuzhny, and Gael Monfils, play the style that normally troubles the Spaniards, so he'll be favored to move on to the final. Wawrinka returns to Chennai as the third seed and the defending champion. He could face top-seeded Janko Tipsarevic in the semifinal, which would be their first meeting on the ATP Tour, despite both men being ranked within the top 50 for several years. Moving on to Brisbane, we could see an interesting matchup between Jürgen Meltzer and Gilles Simon in the third round. On Monday, Simon overcame American Ryan Sweeting in straight sets while Marcos Baghdatis beat Ryan Harrison 7-6, 6-4. On the women's side, Kim Clijsters, Samantha Stosur, and Serena Williams won their first matches of the season in Brisbane. Some of the other top women, including Caroline Wozniacki and Petra Kvitova, are in action at the Hotman Cup in Perth, Australia. For those who don't know, the Hotman Cup is a mixed national team event that has been a warm-up tournament for the Australian Open since 1989. Kvitova and Thomas Burdick are the top-seeded team, followed by Richard Gasquet and Marion Bertoli of France. Play actually started on Saturday when France defeated China 2-1. On Sunday, Spain defeated Australia after Fernando Verdasco and Anibal Medina Garrigues narrowly beat Leighton Hewitt and Jarmila Gajdusova 11-9 in the third set tiebreaker in the deciding mixed doubles match. The Czech Republic and Denmark recorded wins as well, as Kvitova dominated Svetlana Frankova in straight sets, and Thomas Burdick outlasted Grigor Dimitrov in three. Meanwhile, Marty Fish narrowly beat 236th-ranked Fredrik Nielsen in three sets, while Wozniacki beat Bethany Maddox-Sands in straight. Tomorrow, Spain will take on China, and France will face Australia. Andy Murray hired 8-time Grand Slam winner Yvonne Lendl as his new coach on Saturday. Murray will begin working with Lendl as he prepares for the Australian Open, which starts January 16th. The Scot said he was looking forward to working with Lendl because he, quote, brings experience and knowledge that few others have, particularly in major tournaments. The 24-year-old Murray spent all of last season ranked in the top four, but still ended it without a Grand Slam title. Of the new partnership, Lendl said, quote, I am really excited to have the opportunity to work with Andy and that he is a unique talent and I look forward to trying to help him reach his goals. Murray reached the Australian Open final and the semifinals of the other three Grand Slams last season. He has lost in two other major finals, the 2010 Australian Open and the 2008 US Open. US Open champion Samantha Stosur has signed a new apparel and shoe deal with ASICS, and she has already started wearing their gear at the Brisbane International this week. Meanwhile, Yonex has signed Stanislas Wawrinka and Bernard Tomic. Wawrinka and Tomic will use the Vcore 98D, and Wawrinka will also wear the company's shoes and clothes. That'll do it from us. Remember to check us out at tennisnow.com to stay informed on all that's going on in tennis, and follow us on Facebook and Twitter for up-to-the-minute updates. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel to see when we put up new content. As always, thanks for watching and have a great week, everybody.